Hi there, everyone. Hopefully your preparation is going well. Today we are uploading the most important lesson on logarithm and indices. If you are generally facing problem with questions on logs or indices, we strongly recommend you to go through this video first. In the video lesson, you will not only understand the properties in details, but also the relationship between logs and indices should be clear to you once you have watched the lesson. This lesson is actually part of the topic preparation at MathLittery courses and has been extracted from the same. Do check the CAT comprehensive course in our website and also the capsule courses and choose the one which best suits your need. Without any further ado, let me share the lesson with you all now. Leave a thumbs up to the video if you enjoyed it and also leave any suggestion or feedback to the video in the comment section below. Whenever we have something like this, the question is 2 raised to what power is 8, right? Answer is 3. So 2 raised to 3 will give us 8. So the relationship between indices and logs goes like this. So if you have b to the power p is equal to n, some base raised to some power is equal to n, then log of n to this base b will be equal to the power. Basically, what the idea is, if you keep the base constant, so in this case and this case, indices and log are simply inverse of each other. If the power is the input and the number is the output, that is indices. And if the number is the input and the power is the output, that is log. Let us relate some of the properties here. Let's start with a very basic property. So if I have a to the power b multiplied to a to the power c, so effectively what are we doing? We are a to the power b itself is a multiplied b number of times. And then we are multiplying to that a c number of times. So effectively what we have done is we have multiplied a b plus c times. If you look at this, if the numbers are multiplied, these are the numbers, right? If they get multiplied, then the powers get added. So if we do this, log of x base b plus log of y base b. So if you're adding the powers, please understand log itself is a power, right? The output is a power. This itself is a power. This itself is a power. If you're adding the powers, then the numbers which are here should get multiplied, isn't it? So this will be the result. So log of x plus log of y to the same base will be log of x times y. Similar idea. So if I have a to the power b divided by a to the power c, it can be actually one of two things. One thing, suppose you have b greater than c. Okay, so you have more number of a's multiplied in the numerator than you have the number of times a is multiplied in the denominator. So if you have more number of a's in the numerator, after the cancellation happen, you will be left with some a's, and that is b minus c times. B minus c a's in the numerator. Example, you have 5 2's multiplied in the numerator and 3 2's multiplied in the denominator. So the result will be a couple of 2's left in the numerator. That is 5 minus 3. Similarly, if I have this b less than c, in this case, we should have the something left in the denominator because c is more than b, right? So if c is more than b, then there will be something left in the denominator. And how much will that be? Obviously, c minus b. Now, this itself is telling us a couple of things. Number one is this. So number one, let me use this to explain. So this is equal to a to the power b by a to the power c, right? So if I am dividing the numbers, the powers are getting subtracted. So if we do this, if we subtract the powers, effectively the numbers should get divided. Another thing that I understand from this itself, see, these two are the same thing, right? Both of these are equal to this, a to the power b by a to the power c. It just depends on whether b is greater than c or b is less than c. So both of these should be equal. So what is happening here? So if I consider this b minus c or c minus b, either of them as x, the other one is what? Minus x. Let me put it in this way. If a is raised to a negative power, and I want to make this power positive, then the a will go to the denominator, or the number itself will go to the denominator. So if I make the power negative to positive, the number itself reciprocates. So if I have something like this, let's say, log itself is a power, right? So if I convert this to positive power, this x should go to the denominator, that is the number. Coming to an interesting thing, how much is a to the power 0? So a to the power 0 is basically what? A to the power x minus x, right? Same thing, Now we already understood this from this property that a to the power b minus c will be a to the power b by a to the power c. So this should be equal to what? A to the power x upon a to the power x. This will be equal to 1 provided a is not equal to 0, because 0 by 0 will be indefinite, right? So a to the power 0 will be 1 provided the base is non-zero. Now remember, we've already discussed this in function. The base of the log can never be 0 anyhow. The base of a log will be positive real numbers except 1. So if I consider something like this, or if I take the log of 1, so if the number is 1, the power should be 0, right? So log 1 is always 0 for any acceptable base of log. Now, let us get into a few interesting things. Number one is this. What is the essence of this? A to the power b whole to the power c. What is the meaning of this? It's like a to the power b into a to the power b into a to the power b c number of times. So this is what is happening, right? A to the power b into a to the power b into a to the power b, a total of c number of times. So if we multiply this c number of times, each multiplication will result in addition of the powers, right? So you're effectively adding b plus b c number of times, isn't it? And that should be what? A to the power b into c. So if I have something like this, and this x is now raised to a power, now please understand, log itself is a power, right? So if you're raising that with another power, so effectively what is happening? The power should get multiplied. So this is another property. Let's get to another interesting one. I'll elaborate this with an example. This is very logical, but with examples, you'll better understand. I mean, the next few things that we are going to discuss, I'm going to take some examples to elaborate this, okay? So first thing, this is very easy. 2 cube is equal to 8. So 2 should be equal to 8 to the power 1 by 3. So if I say log of 8 base 2, that is 3, then log of 2 base 8. So this is asking us a question that which power of 2 is 8. This is asking us a question which power of 8 is 2. So this should obviously be reciprocal of the previous one, isn't it? So the property is something like this. Log of a base b will always be equal to 1 by log of b base a. Next thing, 2 cube is equal to 8 and 2 to the power 4 is equal to 16, right? So suppose I need to find the power of 8, which gives us 16. What I'm trying to do is, instead of going directly from 8 to 16, let me take a route via 2. Okay, so from 8, I'll move to 2, and then I'll go to 16. First, from 8 to 2, if I have to go, I have to take 1/3 power, and then I need to raise it to 4 to get a 16. Or in turn, what are we getting? 8 to the power 4 by 3. So this is the power, right? Similar idea, if we do it in log, so if I say, suppose log 16 base 8. So what we can do is, first of all, I'll move from 8 to 2, but when I'm moving from 8 to 2, I'm doing this, right? Which power of 8 is 2, something like that. And then I'm multiplying that to log of 16 base 2. First, I move from 8 to 2, that is our first question, 1/3 power. And then we have this. But remember, this log 2 base 8 is also log 1 by log 8 base 2. So can't I write something like this? The idea is, I mean, here I've just taken 2 for an example. It's not mandatory that you have to use 2 as the base or something which is giving us integer powers as a base. It's not mandatory. I can take any base. I can, move through 3 as well if I want. I can move through 4, 5, 7, whatever. I can move through any base. So the idea is something like this: log of x base y will be equal to log of x base b upon log of y base b. So if I have something like this, I can just divide into log x by log y, but the base should be common then, as it is in this case. And the last property that we're going to discuss, it uses that inverse idea. Do you remember that f inverse fx is always equal to x? So a couple of things we can do. One is something like this, 2 and then 2 cube. So this will always be equal to 3, because what we are essentially doing is we are inputting 3 into this function, this indices function, and then taking an inverse of that. So the answer should always be 3, the input. But then f of f inverse x should also be equal to x, right? So if I do something like this as well, this will also be 3. This is x, So this 2 to the power x is 3, right? So that is the idea. So if this is x, then finally we get 2 to the power x, and that is equal to 3, right? So input output interchange, so something like that. So the properties is this thing is fine. I mean, you can anyhow figure it out. So but still I'm writing a dot. I mean, you can use a property of that, the power coming down, to understand this. This is easy to understand. But this one you should be aware of. The same thing, just using inverse idea. Somewhat similar to this idea is this. See, first thing, log of 8 base 2 is what? 3. And we are raising 16 by that much. So this is 16 cube. Right. Now, another thing, what will be this? This thing is 4. And we are raising 8 by 4, right? But understand one thing, 16 is 2 to the power 4, right? Which is this, 4. So this is 2 to the power 4 whole cube. And this is 2 cube whole to the power 4. Is there any difference between these two? Same thing, right? So the idea is this. I mean, this part is 2 to the power 4 and this part is 2 cube. Similarly, this part is 2 cube and this part is 2 to the power 4. So as we are taking the base as 2, and I'm thinking in terms of 2, okay? So I can take any base and I can just simplify that accordingly. So the end result will be 2 to the power this 4 into 3 in both the cases, right? It has to be. So if I take a random value, so suppose not integer values, for example, so 5 and something like this, and let's say this. Okay, so irrational numbers. So suppose we assume that 5 is 2 to the power x and 3 is 2 to the power y. So this thing is what? 2 to the power x into y. And this thing is 2 to the power y into x. It's the same thing, right? So can you look at the transition now? So what is happening? So if you compare these two, what is happening is essentially this. X raised to log of y to the base b is always same as y raised to log of x base b. If you just interchange this x and y, it doesn't make any difference. It's the same thing. Okay, got all that?
If you plan to prepare with us in a structured manner, then do check the courses in our website. In the CAT comprehensive course, you will not only be prepared for each topic for CAT, ZAT, NMAT, SNAP, IFT, but you will also have a one-to-one guidance and doubt clearing throughout your preparation. The workshops, mocks, and sectional tests will prepare you for strategy and decision-making in the tests. The GDPI VAT preparation is also included in the course, making it a one-stop preparation hub for CAT and other management entrance tests of India. Take a trial of this course and check the way we have trained before you make the actual purchase. For both CAT as well as GMAT, we also offer the option to attend the classes live and one-to-one with mentor. Depending on whether you are preparing for CAT or GMAT, check the relevant course among these two. You will have the option to take the full course or customize the sessions as per your requirement. For instance, you may purchase hours for just doubt clearing or mock analysis or any specific topic. Simply book a demo with us and have an experience of our one-to-one sessions. We also have mini courses, which we call the capsules, customized for you to select specific areas and train yourself. For each specialized area of training, you'll be trained everything from basics to all types of applications and variations of that particular topic. If you are looking to strengthen your understanding of specific areas of any section, which are tested in CAT, GMAT, or any other aptitude tests, then this will be the perfect course for you. Each capsule will have video lessons as well as practice sets covering all areas of that topic with video explanation of each question that are discussed in the practice sets. Every course at MathReTree is designed to provide flexibility and complete support as per students' requirement. We will always be there to guide you and help you prepare as best as we can. Simply visit our website and check the relevant course. Book a demo with us or take a trial of the course and make the right choice as per your need. Thank you for joining in and have a pleasant preparation ahead.